Hello everybody, Low Battery Dane here, and today I'm going to be doing an original tag called the Vegan Tag, or the Vegan Food Book Tag, or the Book Vegan Tag, or whatever you want to call it really, or whatever I've called it in the description and title, I suppose.
Dane Reads.
So this came about, I was having a chat with somebody and I can't remember who. I actually already filmed this and cocked it up, so I'm doing it again. And this is a book tag, 10 questions based on vegan food. So I'm just finding me prompts here. The vegan booktube tag, that's what I called it. We're gonna jump straight in with the questions. No food footage for you because I am lazy. Question one, tofu. Name a writer who's super versatile. So I'm gonna go for Isaac Asimov. The man published, I think, like 500 plus books in his lifetime. He published across 9 of the 10 major Dewey Decimal categories as well. So the guy could write just a little bit of everything and still make it interesting as well. Question number two, nuts. Name a book that was batshit crazy. Oh yeah, this is the question I asked in some vegan groups for people to suggest questions, and the only feedback I got was that this question was offensive. But hey ho, I think they're nuts. So, a book that was batshit crazy. Well, In the Miso Soup by Ryu Murakami. I don't know whether there's any nuts in miso soup, or even if it's vegan. That book was batshit crazy. That's how one of my friends sold it to me. He was like, this book is one of the craziest books you'll ever read. I don't know if it's the craziest book I've ever read, but it's the craziest one I've read recently, so we'll go with that. Question number three, nutritional yeast. Name a book that's super cheesy. Any cheesy poetry collections. Like Milk and Honey by Rupi Kaur, which by the way, I did like, but it was a little bit cheesy at times, you know? Question number four, Beyond Burger. Name a book that imitates another book. So for me, I'm going to go for Northern Lights or any of the books in the His Dark Materials trilogy by Philip Pullman. I have a Panzer Bjorn tattoo here. There he is, saying hello. You see my tan going on here. And it is sort of a retelling or a loose retelling of Paradise Lost. And I love it. It's great. My favourite book ever. Question number five, quinoa. Name a book that's a good base book that everyone should read. Okay, well, probably one of the classics. Like To Kill a Mockingbird, maybe, by Harper Lee. Yeah, probably that. Or if you're into horror, like Dracula by Bram Stoker. Yeah, we'll go with those. Question number six, almond milk. Name a book that goes well with a cup of tea. Any book. One that goes specifically well with tea. I mean, I guess... what's it, the book from the Parasol Protectorate. I didn't actually like that book though, but there was a lot of tea drinking in that. We'll go with The Suspicions of Mr. Witcher by Kate Summerscale, because nothing says tea like Victorian true crime murder. Question number seven, environmentalism. Name a book that's about art or another planet. Midworld by Alan Dean Foster. That one just popped straight into my head. I can't remember the name of the planet, but I picked that up after Todd the Librarian recommended it, and it was great. Question number eight, animal rights. Name a book that's sympathetic towards animals. Obviously, Meat by Dane Cobain. That's actually the book. The research for that book is what turned me vegan, because I used to be vegetarian, and I wanted to write a novel set on a factory farm, because I was like, trying to think of like horrifying settings where it's quite easy to do horror because it's just automatically horrifying just being there. And so that took me to factory farms, and then I did a lot of research into what's going on there, and I was like, well, can't really justify just being vegetarian now, it's vegan or nothing. Question number nine, health. Name a book that inspired you to be healthier mentally or physically. So for me, that would be What I Talk About When I Talk About Running by Haruki Murakami. Basically, he used to work in a bar, and then he quit his job and gave himself a year to make it as a writer, but he realized he was getting really out of shape, so he quit the fags, cigarettes, sorry, it wasn't a, you know, I'm not being homophobic, it's just UK slang that has nothing to do with that. There's also the term fagging, which is like when you get like public school kids, they get their fags, which are like, you get like the head of year or whatever, like the head boy. They get like the young kids to be their fags, which means like they have to make their beds for them and It's a bit, it's almost like how hazing works at American universities with, American colleges with freshmen. Anyway, I'm going off on a right tangent. What was the question? Oh yeah, so he quit the cigarettes and he took up running and he loved it. And yeah, he was about a similar age to I was when I first read that book, and it kind of inspired me to be healthier as well. And question number 10, cross-contamination. Tag some friends. So, I mean, if you're vegan, take this. If you're not, take it anyway. I'll tag the usual crew. So Todd the Librarian, we'll tag Regina's Bookish Library, Charlie Heathcote, Harriet Rosie, because I know Charlie and Harriet are both vegetarian. Mindy's Book Journey, we'll tag Jason's Weird Reads. We'll do Mary Amoronsky. But also, if you want to take this tag, feel free to take it. I'll tag Attention and aim for Narida, actually. Why not? So, there we have it. Short and simple. Book tag. Vegan food book tag. It came out of a conversation I had with somebody in my comments, and I now can't remember who it was. I did remember when I first filmed this, but as I say, I had to film it again. So sorry about that. As always, let me know in the comments if you've read any of these books, and if so, what you thought of them. Hit that like button if you've enjoyed this video. Hit that subscribe button for more, and I'll see you soon for another bookish video. Thanks a lot. Vegan propaganda. Yeah.